little girls, they come out here for the sun, the sea, the sand, and the sex. They save up for 2 weeks holiday, and they come out here and just let their hair down. And there's these lovely Greek waiters and barmen willing to help them.
Δεν μπορεί χωρίς γυναίκα. Λοιπόν, το αρέσουν οι γυναίκες από παλιά και όπου μπορεί και όπου βρίσκει πηγαίνει με γυναίκα. Μετά ξέρει ότι έχει έρθει για διακοπές εδώ. Θέλει να ζήσει τη ζωή της. Να βγει, να διασκεδάσει, να χορέψει, να πιει και ό,τι προκύψει πιο αισθητό.
They treat you like a princess, they treat you like the queen. Okay, they're the king, but they do treat you like a queen. They really romance you, and it's not all bullshit. Not all of it.
That is one of my ones I call better than sex. There's a few things on the menu, and I was like, oh, it's better than sex. And then people say to me, well, it was nice, but it weren't better than sex. And I say, well, you ain't slept with my husband.
It's romantic. You're in a romantic atmosphere. You're eating outside at night, music, you're relaxed. You've been on the beach all day. And at night time, Saganaki and sex. There are thousands of girls that have married Greek people. It's just a way of life.
Hello, Alfredos. Hello, welcome to Zakynthos. Do you know what you're seeing?
Maria.
Are you the Wilshers times two?
Yep.
Okay, your coach number six, please. I'd just like to pop your bags on the side. Thank you. You're on coach six.
They have a different romance. They're powerfully romantic.
Are there six of you?
Sure they are, after Englishmen. I was one of the ones at Felfridge.
Hello, Alfredos. So we're now heading directly from the airport to your resort, and I'd just like to welcome you to the island of Zakynthos, one of the greenest and most beautiful of the seven Ionian islands.
I was a personal assistant secretary in a publishing company before I came out here on holiday. And that's when I met Nonios.
So please, don't ruin your holiday in the first few days by getting burnt. That's the only warning I shall make. Just have a nice, relaxing holiday now.
Oh, this one. Well, these both, actually. This one is in the first week of us meeting together. I recognise that bikini. I recognise that. I think our first... Well, certainly wasn't our first night, but certainly first three or fourth of 1982, when we first met. We were looking each other in the eyes, love. Of course, my husband, he was a farmer. He was picking melons, and that was a melon he'd brought down for me and my girlfriend to eat that afternoon. I mean, I looked very much different then, but yeah. Brown as a berry, holiday maker, tourist.
We've got too many clothes. Hands up. Okay, thank you very much. You'd like to follow me this way?
We used to be able to count the old girls, from 11 years ago. We used to be able to count on two hands the English that stayed here. There must be at least 3,000 now. There have to be. And it's only a tiny island, you must remember. It's only the size of the Isle of Wight.
Okay. Thank you. You're right. Got everybody behind us?
It came to me, the island, rather than me going looking for it. I wasn't a traveller, I had never any interest to go anywhere else. I liked the UK and I had no dreams of moving. Very happy at home. and I'd found a utopia. I can really just say that. I knew I was home. And I didn't mean going home at night, but home, you know. It was the beginning, really, of a love affair of the island. It was so unchanged, it was so natural, it was so Greek then. It just drew my heart. It was all so different for me. I was probably the only foreigner in that room, I think, that year. And for a few years after, the only foreigner. I stood out, I felt I stood out. It was odd feeling. And wearing trousers. I was probably the only female in trousers that Christmas as well. Going out with bouzouki and trousers. We had 8 years, really, of inseparability, day and night, and I mean that. Even let somebody look at these shooters' face. I used to go shooting with him, with his dogs. I've been hare hunting with him in the early hours of the morning, holding his torch, you know, and holding his dog. So, I've been there. I've been there with him, so... Yeah, but looking back, yes, we had a lot of fun in those days. A lot of fun. Yes.
Two burgers for children. Two fillets of blackie. What do you want me?
What fillets of blackie? Have you got chicken fillets, or pork?
Chicken, please.
Chicken?
My sister telephoned me one day. She said, looked in the paper and there's a square deal. It is a Zakynthos. So where's that? I've never heard of it before. She said, it's Greece.
Yeah.
And the first restaurant we came to, we went in and we looked at the menu and we said, oh, I like the menu. And I said, well, I like the waiter. All the time we was laughing and joking, taking photographs of him when he wasn't looking and that, and thinking, oh, is he going to serve us tonight? And he served us every night.
All right. I'll put that under there because it's a bit windy.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Good boy.
Thank you very much. You'd have to say it in Greek.
Ask the lady how to say it in Greek, Sam.
Say it in Greek.
How do you say it in Greek?
Say F.
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 Harry's.
Harry's.
Toe.
Harry.
F. Harry's toe.
F. Harry's toe.
Mia filetto, I keep busy. Mia special.
The woman whose husband ran the restaurant, the woman was English. I said to her, what's that little waiter's name? And she said, oh, that's Nico. I said, has he got a girlfriend or is he married? She said, no, why? And I said, because I think he's really nice. She said, that's really funny because every time you come in, he serves your table because he thinks you're nice. Anyway, I waited till he'd finished work and we went out for a drink.
So, lady?
Yes, please.
I didn't know what to say to him because I didn't speak any Greek at all. And he only knew to say, what would you like for drink? Was that nice? Did you enjoy? Which is pretty handy, really.
You right, Phil?
Burger.
No, you're beef burger. You like beef burger.
It's like McDonald's.
After what do you want for a drink and did you enjoy your meal, we were a bit stuck. So we just like sitting next to each other at the bar. And I was looking in one direction, he was looking the other and that, and just sort of smiling at each other. And then I think he was pretty fed up with this, so he just turned around and just kissed me. So, didn't he, darling? You mad fool. If you'd not done that, you know, I would have got on that aeroplane and you'd never have seen me again.
Yeah.
Bad luck. As I was on the coach, there was young girls getting off, coming out the hotels, and their waiters were bringing their bags on and they were crying and that. Yes, I will write to you. And I thought, you know, get a life. Grow up, you know, it's got another girl waiting as soon as, like, you go. But, you know, I thought, yeah, fair enough, he's a nice bloke. And we'll see. But he said, please phone me when you get back to England to make sure you know, you got back OK. And I did. Like, I left it a couple of days, but I phoned him.
Ξεκίνησε σαν αστείο, όχι σαν αστείο, ξεκίνησε σαν κάτι ότι διακοπές, μια απλή περιπέτεια τελείως, που δεν, ποτέ μου δεν είχα περιπέτεια με άλλη Αγγλίδα, απλώς έτσι το είδα.
Λάγανα.
Nice food.
Nice food.
Πατάτε λίγο.
You were so new to me, having men run after you with such vigour, with such passion, whereas in the UK, men actually don't run after you. You have to be a female, really, to understand how incredibly female they make you feel after London, especially after publishing or tourism. You have to be on the same, you have to be strong and hard, and they made you feel quite feminine. He followed me continually for that 2 weeks holiday with my girlfriend, much to her amazement. And I was flattered, and of course, I think there was love. There was love between us both. Neither of us would admit it then. Then, in fact, that's what it was. But he asked me to stay and live with him up in the farm the first week I was here, or the first 2 weeks, and said, don't go back. He was very romantic in those days. Flowers in his pocket for me, back pockets. Nobody would see them, of course, but he would give it to me when we were on our own. Of course, I fell for it. I fell for it incredibly strongly. I didn't want to go back. And I knew that was virtually it. I knew that he was my life, much to the horror of my parents. And also fiancé, of course, I'd left behind. Friends and family, really, were... I think they thought maybe I would get over it. Let Susie do it and come back and she'll get over it. But in fact, I didn't ever. Once I'd been away, that was it. I saw a different life. I moved in the September of 1982 and he brought me straight up. I thought I was coming to a rent room. And I thought, this is a long way, up this mountain road to a rent room. And he brought me straight here into the family home. Two brothers and his mother sharing the same everything. He was... a great culture shock to me because we used to privacy back in the UK. He never had any heirs. You know, he said, I'm a farmer and my name is Nunez.
Been here, what, just over a year now. And Nico and I have got a little boy called Taffy. We're living in Nico's mum and dad's house. We've got a bedroom and a little lounge. Two rooms, that's it. We're not married yet. We're working hard this summer. We're saving up for the wedding, Nico and I, because we've got to pay for everything. Takes a lot of money and I want to do it right. And then I've got to get Tassie baptised, but I want to get that done first.
When I
am... Yeah, Tassis. Very name, Tassis.
you call Tassi, but you must write Tassis.
This is so what is it? Tass, Alpha, Sigma?
Eta?
No.
Sigma.
Tassis.
Προσπαθώ να σας εξηγήσω τώρα την ελληνική γραμματική.
Αναστάσιο.
Ότι αλλιώς το φωνάζεις.
Ναι.
Λέει γιατί να γράψουμε τάσεις και να μην γράψουμε τάση. Λέω αλλιώς το φωνάζεις το παιδί και αλλιώς το γράφεις στη γραμματική.
Έτσι. Όχι στο μωρό.
Η Πόπη είναι Καλλιόπη. Καλλιόπη.
Καλλιόπη.
Ναι.
Ναι. Yeah, oh no, I don't like that.
Yeah.
The first time I met them, I was 6 months pregnant. I'd never met them before. They didn't want to meet me. If they had, it's like acknowledging me, accepting me. So I met them, I was 6 months pregnant when I moved out here. And they were wonderful, really lovely. They didn't want me to lift a finger, do anything because I was pregnant.
I thought they were wonderful anyway. I didn't know that they were talking about me behind my back because I didn't understand the language. If I wanted to get up at 11 o'clock in the morning because I'd had a bad night's sleep because the baby kicking, it's no problem. You sleep. You do what you want. The minute the baby's born, different because the baby's out of my body now. So you don't have to treat me well because I'm not carrying the baby anymore. Totally different. If he doesn't want this, I'll take a picture of the bones out.
Nico's mum just wanted to take over the baby. Tassie's half English as far as I'm concerned, and I do things my way. Their ways are totally different from my ways anyway. After I'd had the baby, I wasn't allowed out of the front door for 40 days. Something to do with the church I don't really understand. So I'm stuck in the house all day. It drives me crazy. Nico's working all day and the nights. I didn't hardly see him. I got a few English friends here and I went out with one of my friends on the beach. And she, Nico's mother, screamed and shouted because I've been out of the house all day with a baby.
She took the baby off of me and checked that he wasn't red or anything, and she thought I was going to leave him in the sunshine to burn. She just created. She said, oh, you're wrong, you're wrong, you're bad. She was shouting in Greek to me, Kako. It was really... And I just said to Nico, what was all that about? And I said, I haven't got my life. So he spoke to them. When he took me to work, he spoke to them and said, if this happens again, we're either going to cement the door up to our part of the house and never go in your part of the house, or we don't care if we can't afford it, we'll move out, we'll rent somewhere else.
And they're pretty good now.
The baby yet, lot.
So how much Greek do you actually understand?
Fair bit of it. Depends on how...
Yeah.
How tired I am. Sometimes I can understand it, but can't be bothered to try and translate it. So it's easier for me to say, what did they say? But I understand more than I let on. Because then they can talk freely.
Εγώ, ας πούμε, τώρα δεν ξέρω, είτε γλέζει, μόνο ελληνικά, τίποτα. Άλλα μου λέει γλία, ειδία, αλλά εγώ. Να κάνω το καραγκιόζο. Έτσι δεν είναι. Ξέρεις εσύ. Σιγά, σιγά, εγώ τώρα, ας πούμε, άλλη ζωή δική μας. Άλλη της ειδίας. Εσάς, άλλη, όλοι. Εγώ, ας πούμε, θα σηκωθώ πρωί. Θα σηκωθώ, θα ετοιμάσω το φαΐ πρωί-πρωί. Να κάνω τις δουλειές στο σπίτι. 12 η ώρα το τραπέζι, θα ετοιμαστεί να φάμε. Εντάξει. Δεν είναι η γλώσσα μόνο. Ας πούμε, έχω ένα αγόρι. Προτιμούσα να πάρει ελληνίδα.
Αναστάσιο.
Βλέπει να καταλάβει. Εγώ είμαι 73 χρονών, έδιαν 28. Να πάρει τη σειρά πώς θα γίνει μια νοικοκυρά καλή. Εμείς δεν έχουμε πολύ περιουσία. Έχουμε ένα σπίτι. Όταν φύγει, πρέπει να πληρώνει ενίκιο. Εντάξει. Γιατί τα λεφτά αυτά θα μπουν μέσα στο σπίτι. Θα ζήσουμε όλοι μαζί.
Sometimes I'm sitting in the bedroom on my own, listening to them all screaming and shouting at each other in the other room, thinking, what am I doing here? But then Nico walks in, and then I know what I'm doing here.
Alison Turner and her husband run a small restaurant in Kent. After starting a family, they decided to give up their life in London and move out to the country. Of course, Alison doesn't know this yet because she still works as a recruitment consultant in the city. But when she does, our pensions and investments will be flexible enough to adapt whatever path she chooses. Clerical medical, the choice of the professional.
Yeah, the worst thing about New York is the cab drivers. I mean, they never know where they're going.
Yeah, but what about all those great clothes shops?
You've got great shops too.
Maybe. But the absolute best thing about New York is the food. You can walk straight into a deli any time, and they'll make you up a massive sandwich the size of a skyscraper. Gorgeous fillings. You just don't get in sandwiches over here.
You've obviously been away too long.
New Hellman's Deli Sandwich Mayonnaise. Four ways to make any sandwich delicious.
Simon and Garfunkel, their definitive collection. It has to be one of the greatest albums of all time.
PolyGrip Ultra holds dentures more firmly than ever and keeps out irritating bits of food. It's perfect on any plate.
Does your sleep pattern sometimes get disturbed? Now there's a new liquid-filled gel capsule, Sleepier. Sleepier can help you drift off to a good night's sleep and wake up feeling refreshed. Sleepier helps restore your natural sleep pattern.
It's nowhere as easy where you're going to Liverpool, or do you think it is? It's not. The island is very traditional. Once I moved here, I was more than a girlfriend. I was a main fixture, and I was then being told that I couldn't talk to other people without asking first. And I had to sit in my chair and not wave across bars, and that was not acceptable. It was not the done thing. I had to sit on my chair and wait for people to come to me. My mother said to me a little while ago, I don't know how it came up, we were talking about something from the past. She said that she would never have allowed me to have lived here. Had she heard anything on the island about me? And I'm not saying I'm Miss Goody Two Shoes. I mean, I knew the rules. I knew what was right and wrong. And that's not getting up out of a chair. That was hard to actually handle for me, that I couldn't go and say hello and see people that I wanted to see when I was with my boyfriend. We had many fights over that. That discipline that he instilled in me. We'd had many rows over those kind of rules that only applied to me. It didn't apply to him. And they were the crying years, the very painful crying years, which really was 84. That year seemed longer than it was. Looking back, it was probably only a year of anguish. I didn't like it, but I live with it now. I know the rules.
Come on. Come on in, quickly. Where are you going to
play? Right. Oh, no, you got put in there.
I will go for the cake.
Yeah, and pick the Demetria and Costas.
Yeah.
And then take them to the church. What time are you back here?
After 1 hour.
Okay, then.
Hello.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Oh!
That's it.
Bye-bye, Daddy.
Oh, the next time you see me, Daddy, I'll be drowning. Yes.
Now, leave them alone, because they're not yours to play with. No. I better move these, darling. Don't you?
Yeah, this we give the godmother. You've got to give her a really nice present, so. Here we go. Cost an arm and a leg, but who cares?
We was having arguments last night. My sister-in-law wants to have him fully submerged in the water, right up to the head. Nico said, no, we're not doing that, just up to here, then pour water over him. But she doesn't think it's proper christening if you're not fully submerged, but, I mean, he might go, and swallow loads of water and everything. So I don't think it's totally necessary. So it's just up to there. I told him if there's any problems, I'm going to... There's going to be a funeral the same day. So he's not going to do that.
He must have been saving hard for us.
Working hard, saving hard, yeah. Economy. I haven't bought any food or anything. We've had to be... Mother-in-law's been buying and cooking for us, which is really difficult for me. Because I like to do it myself. My family, I like to cook for my family. It's taking over again, but for a good reason this time.
It took me a long while, actually, to make up my mind whether I'd actually made the right choice. I fought it. I even think that Nunez fought it in a way, because we're both very strong people. I think I thought maybe I could change him, and that I had a home in England and we could spend idyllic 6 months in the summer here and 6 months in the winter. That was my dream. He never said no, but he never actually said yes in those early days. And you've got to know my husband actually to understand the strength of that.
She live in the big city before. Here we live country life. She have a different job there. If she ask me, she used to ask me, right, to go to live there with her. I say, you can stay here or you can go back. I can't live there. I tried before by myself in Athens, in London, everywhere, right? But I like that way of life. I like to be free. I can have my pleasure. I can have my horse, my dog, my hunting.
It took me up until 1989 for me to actually come to terms with everything, to stop dreaming about the UK. Not to sever ties, but we decided to get married. We got married in 1990. We now have two girls. And once we'd made that decision, it calmed all our dreams down.
Some of the English, all right? They are very snob people. Say, I'm English, I don't want to say. I want to stay like I am, I'm English, right? I say, all right, fine enough. You are English, stay in your country. Be with your own people, do anything you like with your own people. Don't expect different people, or Greek people, or Indian, or any, from any country, all right? If you want to go to live in them country, you must learn them language, you must learn them feelings, the way of life. That's make me know it sometimes. Why they expect people to change? What's the point? What for? I never done it, I never can do it.
Has Susie changed much over the years?
She changed. If not enough, she changed enough. If not, she's not Greek, really. She can't be 100%. No, nobody can do it. She's not 100% Greek. But she's still English. But she can live now with the Greek way. Maybe she's not happy 100%. But she's not complaining anymore. That's fair enough.
That we used to come to years ago when we had the horses and we used to water them at the well. My husband said this would always be the spot that we build our house. And I never quite believed it, but we're here. This is our dream home. Well, this is the lounge. This is the lounge area. There's going to be an open fire over where that metal stand is. This is all made out of local stone. Kitchen's going to be over here. That's it, darling, yeah. Be in the bedroom, darling. Just watch your stones. Kitchen area here. We're getting there. And the girls can't wait now. They can't wait to move in. We come here a lot. And it's a beautiful walk. We pick flowers. Often we come down late afternoon when the sun's dropping, but it's a beautiful spot. Normally I feel like a bird up here. It's so high and it's so peaceful up here. And you can see the whole of in fact, half of Zakynthos. I feel very, very, very contented here. We've been together 11 years. It's always nice, especially when you've got children to be able to have your own kitchen, have your own front door. So it would be nice to actually move away from my mother-in-law and be a family at last, at some stage.
I don't hurry too much, you know what I mean? Because if I have a house here, I don't have to pay rent or to worry, you know what I mean? So why do I push my life too much? Another year doesn't make any difference. If I'm not comfortable here, if I'm not have a house, or if I have to pay lots of money for rent, and I'm not happy there. So it's gonna be finished now, long time ago. But since I'm right here, you know what I mean?
It's no hurry, really.
It's no hurry. What's the point? What is the difference? If I go now or 2 years' time? I try to do everything proper, and I take care for the time.
Well, let's take a look at the disaster area. This is the hallway. We've got two bedrooms here and a bathroom in the middle. Here is our bad luck, always our bad luck. About three months ago, we had such rain for 15 days. It brought a boulder out from the hilltop and crashed into two walls. It just appeared. It was there. The architect said, don't worry, build a wall at some stage. But it just slipped through. With so much water, it just slipped out the middle of the earth and just came straight through the bedroom wall. Couldn't have just gone a little to the left, of course. That would have been easy.
Show you something easier, much easier.
I've seen videos of other people's christenings and I'm not looking forward to it at all. But it's got to be done. They do all these things to him, like take all his clothes off and he's submerged in the water. And my mother-in-law holds him and I can't touch him or anything. From the moment I walk into the church, I lose control. It's out of my hands. I don't understand what's going on. I know he's going to be frightened and think, what's all these people? And I can't comfort him. I've got nothing to do with it until the godmother ceremony's over and he's dressed, hands him to me. I just know he's going to want me. And I can't do anything.
Αναστάσιος, να σας ζήσει. Το κατάξει ο Θεέ να καταφύγει από το όνομά σου, επισκέπτον τον Ρίγος, θα διαφυλακτεί να πω σε αυτόν την παλαιάνη εκείνη πλάνη. Ανθρώπων, τη χάρη κυρίσουν το έλεος. Ο κρύβος με εσείς πίσω μόνο γονάς ελευθέρως παραδική να γιάσουμε τον τόκο σε πάσα χτίσει μη σύντημα έντα. Σίγαρο το όσο πήγες όπου θα σώσουν την εσπάρκωμα τον σκέφτες όπου θα Και δώσ' αυτόν τη χάρη σε πολυτρώση ευλογία του Ιουρβάνου πίσω αυταρσίας, πηγή Αγίας Μουδόρο, μάρτυμα του Λιντίνου Ασημάου, το λέξη τύριον δέμος ελεύθριον, της αναντίας δυνάμεις αφρός αγγελικής σχήμα πληρωμένων, για του μονοϊνούς με του και του Παναγίου και αγαθού, της οποίας μεσόνας των αιώνων. Πρόσχομαι. Και τα πόδια του. Εντάξει.
Εντάξει.
Βαπτίζεται ο δούλος του Θεού Αναστάσεως στον όνομα του Πατρός. Αμήν. Και του Υιού. Αμήν. Και του Αγίου Πνεύματος.
It's trying to get back in.
Didn't you?
Yeah, it's all right. I wish I understood it a bit more, though. I didn't like all the interference of my mother-in-law and sister-in-law. But
never mind.
And then Nico said I'd got to kiss the priest. And I said, well, not kissing anyone, I don't know. First go.
No, this one.
Is this the first one?
Can I drive?
Not yet.
Beautiful scenery. Pity you're missing it.
I'm really happy. This is great.
Maybe it's the performance of its 16-valve Ecotec engine, its superb maneuverability and car-like handling. But everyone wants to drive the Sentra, Vauxhall's new MPV.
So when can I drive?
The new Sentra. To drive it is to love it.
If you ever get the chance.
Do you want it now? While I've got the food laid out?
Centival golden churn at last.
Let me just get this top off.
I know you love this. And if you do want any more Centival golden churn, you're going to have to get that trestle up. Yearn for a bit of golden churn.
Some gum problems can leave you exposed to the pain of sensitive teeth. Sensodyne is proven to relieve that pain. And now it contains the antibacterial agent triclosan. Sensodyne F gives complete protection to your teeth and your gums. Used every day, Sensodyne F fights pain, tooth decay, and now helps fight gum disease.
Does your mouth rinse leave you gasping for something more sensitive? Use Sensodyne Mouth Rinse, the gentle giant. Wakes you up gently, every day.
Buy one pair of Boots brand spectacles, then choose another pair, including prescription sunglasses, absolutely free. What a choice from Boots Opticians.
Is that a picture of your daddy?
Well, it was supposed to be a melon, actually. I'll just make it a bit rounder.
Melons. Buy one, get one free.
Strong, thick Domestos can now be mountain fresh, glacier fresh, or even new citrus fresh. Knock 'em dead. Domestos kills all known germs. Dead.
With new organic shampoo, you get organics conditioner free. So you can have more good hair days for less.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Oh, oh, oh. Cast the vibes, the reggae and the ragtime.
There's no single ideal for the way you should look. Only for the way you should feel. That's why New Advantage gives you all the benefits of fibre, but in a light, wheaty flake you'll love.
Έλα, έλα κοντά μου, έλα.
Τα δόκος.
Έλα, μη χαλάσαι τώρα, έλα. Ας κόψε λίγο το μούτρο σου από το φάι σου, έλα.
It's been a tough road from the beginning. It has been tough. I don't pretend it hasn't. And it's all roses. It's not. It's difficult.
Πού θα πας τώρα, πας όξο. Έλα, δεν σε μαμά, έλα. Έλα.
Λίγο κοκοκόλα.
Λίγο κοκοκόλα, περίμενε λοιπόν, έλα.
You know when you've been a business person in the UK, and suddenly you're a nobody because you're a woman and a foreign woman, it's very, very demeaning, and it knocks you sideways. It's funny that you can stop believing that you, in fact, you do have an opinion if nobody listens. And then I stop believing that I was even thinking anything sensible for a while. I don't want to rock the boat too much within my family. I still live with my mother-in-law, so I keep very diplomatic on that side. The Greeks change. My mother warned me. They do change. When you get married and you have children, they do change. Greek men. I mean, I suppose, yeah, I thought maybe I'd find the new man, you know, 1982, but the new man does become the old man. They do change, they do change. They don't want that much to do, really, with the family. We really are on our own. hearts can be broken by expecting a marriage to be an English marriage. The mother-in-law comes first. She is the patriarch, the mother of the marriage. And then the wife comes third or fourth down the line after shooting or dogs.
I keep being told, really think I'm going with my children, you know, if I'm going to a party, as if I shouldn't be seen anywhere. If you don't love somebody enough, it's a difficult life. If you really don't love your husband, I've been unhappy many, many times, and if there'd been a number 21 bus going to Lewisham, I would have been on it, bottom of the road, many times. But the thought of, you know, never seeing Nonius again and, you know, terminating our marriage has stopped me. And I mean that. I don't believe there's anybody, any woman, that is happy all the time.
Exactly, for some reason.
So, free drinks. Thank you. Free drinks tonight.
Do you like that wine? That
Which
wine? That, you know, that if you drop it on the floor, it takes a stain off the floor.
Yeah, I'll drink that.
Right, that's not enough to
drink. Okay, thank you very much.
They leave everything here to the last minute. I was trying to explain to Nico that when we organise weddings in England, they're booked sometimes more than a year before. Nico, did you telephone the video man?
Not yet.
We've paid a lot of money for it. I want it to be really special, and I don't understand what's going on. He doesn't tell me at all. I get really, really stressed.
You telephone the priest?
I go. She telephoned me the night.
Yeah? And?
And after, you know.
So who are you waiting for, to telephone? Who's got to telephone you?
Priest. No one here, maybe.
Oh, right. It's not the easy life that I thought it was going to be. Put it like this, I thought it was just going to be one long holiday, which of course, as a tourist, you always do. We open two bars and a restaurant together. He leaves about 4 in the afternoon and is home the following morning, 3:30, 4. And then we allow him to sleep as much as he can. And then he's up and he does the animals. There's always something to be done on the farm. I joke and say I could be a single mother. I bring up the children on my own. It's very difficult some days. And to be so far from everybody, from my mum and my dad and my family, that's really when you start having self-doubt. And dad's maybe about everything.
Go and have a look in there for eggies. We're going to have a look now. Hang on. We're going to look for some eggs now.
I'm sure we've spoken about young girls who've come over, 20 or 22, and they've had no life in England, no jobs, and They come here and they're expected just to be in the house and serve the husbands and bring the food. Don't go out ever. Don't have any friends. Don't speak unless you're spoken to. And they can't cope with it. And they have children quickly. And everything goes wrong. They're stuck in the house with often a mother-in-law. Maybe they know the language. It's quite often it's better that they don't know the language, because once you start learning the language, it becomes even harder. And I've lost many good friends.
So if there's a rabbit in the hole there?
Those that have left have obviously left because they are desperately unhappy, or were desperately unhappy. And nobody's come back. All those that have gone, actually gone on the last ferry or on the first aeroplane, have not come back. It's not a warning, a warning cry. You don't make warning cries to a Greek man. If you go, you go, and there's no coming back.
Έλα, δώσε την Νικόλα, λοιπόν. Έλα.
I'm still not 100% happy every day. I wake up and think, oh, I'd rather be elsewhere. I'd rather be with my mum today, or everybody feels that. I don't believe anybody's ever 100% happy all the time. Maybe that's really the whole point of it, is that I've actually come to terms with myself, where I said I've changed. It's learning to be happy and not needing anybody else. I'm like a little sailing boat now, just happy just to go with the wind, and I mean that. I can't explain it. But I'm not giving up. I'm not going to give up. Not yet.
Mrs. Tox. What's your stinky feet? How many stinky feet?
We got it all finalised today, where we're having the reception and the wedding's tomorrow. Just silly little things like that. Everything's last minute. Never mind. In the end, yesterday, when he came home, I was going to have an early night, but he didn't come home till one. In the end, I said, right, let's just forget it then. Let's not bother. But we made it up. Nerves. I've got a way with not getting married all these years. And now I'm doing it.
Δεκάτα πρώτα χρόνια είναι δύσκολα στο γάμο. Τα θα συνηθίσεις. Μία εβδομάδα ολόκληρη και ένα μήνα τρέχω. Χάρτια, γλυκά, μπουμπουνιέρες, εκκλησίες, τα πάντα. Αύριο θα είναι όλα έτοιμα. Δούμε.
That'd be really lovely. It's about time. I mean, because me and Nico knew right from the start that that's what we wanted, so it just seems to have been a long time coming, really. We had Tessie, so that was another expense. Christening, another expense. So you work this summer just to get married. It'd be lovely.
Είναι μεγάλη μέρα, πολύ μεγάλη. Πιστεύω και η νύχτα να είναι το ίδιο.
I had my friend here last night chatting away to me. She was talking about when she got married and I was going, oh. Mind you, it's nice, I mean, because I've never been married before, you forget that people come round and they bring in presents and everything, you know. And, oh, this is nice. It's better than Christmas. It's really good. So, it'll be nice tomorrow. Mrs. Gossetti. Mrs. Gossetti. That'll be nice.
And you're invited to join Mr. and Mrs. Gossetti as they tie the knot in traditional Greek style when Island of Dreams continues next Tuesday at 9 o'clock here on 4.
didn't fancy Greece. Never been to Greece, didn't fancy Greece. But oh well, it's only for 1 week. I got up Tuesday morning and went out on the balcony and looked, and it was beautiful. So that was it. Fell in love with the place. Everyone in the restaurant, when they said, oh, what's an English girl doing working at here? Oh, you're a Shirley Valentine. And I used to get upset about that. I said, I'm not Shirley Valentine, because with Shirley Valentine, when she came back to her Greek man, he was chatting up another girl. And I know my Nico wasn't like that. I mean, there are thousands of girls that are falling in love with Greek people.
What's your dress?
It's just a way of life.
Okay.
Yeah. Getting married tomorrow. Can't believe it. They usually get a baby boy and roll it over the bed so that if you have children, it's lucky and you hope you have a boy first. A bit late now, really. Yeah, she's just made it, and she called Nico to have a look at it, and I caught them having a cuddle, and mother-in-law was crying. And then Nico saw my wedding dress in there, all in the covers. He said, oh, what's that, the wedding dress? I had to drag him away from it. Oh, I'm really excited now. Oh. Any mention of bed? Everyone thought it was just a holiday romance. I'd only known him for 4 weeks. My sister said to me, and my friend said, you must be really, really stupid. Or really brave. And I said, well, I'm not stupid.